that is a third-party upgrade kit for the Fall of Cybertron Grimlock.
Hallelujah! Honestly, the reason I bought this guy, when I did, was because I saw this was coming out. This is the Cretaceous Advancement set made by Zenith Forge. I think it's actually their first third-party item. Now, what is really, really neat about this is when I was debating, should I buy this, should I not, is it worth it? I found the video review by Customs by Z on YouTube. He's actually the designer behind this, so it was really neat just to see this thing being opened up by its creator and hearing the backstory behind it, what he did in terms of 3D printing and all that kind of stuff. So if you want to learn more about the process behind this, watch this video. I'm going to link it in the description. It's worth checking out. It really sold me on this kit. So thanks a lot, Z, for that. So this is the set. Now this thing, it's $30. I'm going to tell you right now, it is $30. And that's a bit hefty for what it is. But you have to remember, this is a third-party item. It's not a mass-produced thing. It's made in very, very low numbers. So keep that in mind when you are getting it. Now what is included in the set? Woo! Look at all that fun stuff. We get a shield, a sword, a filler piece for the dino mode, as well as an alternate head if you are so inclined to get a different head, along with some little connector bits that I'll get to. You open it up, it's very, very easy, okay? Now, don't freak out. This isn't a hard process. All you do, you cut the tape, all right? You open it up. Don't worry. It's not going to jump out at you. Don't worry. It's okay. We're in this together. Oh, there we go. And that is it. That is your whole set. Packaged very nicely, very simple. And I really love this set. This is exactly what I wanted. This is every issue that I had with Grimlock, this fixes it. And I adore this set. Now, the only thing you will need to really do this is a precision flathead screwdriver that I have just dropped. And honestly, you will only need this if you intend to replace the head. If you don't want to, it's understandable. I'm really torn on which head I like more myself. So, I'm gonna use this as a little prying tool. Look at that. Look at that, it's a multi-tool. It's a multi-functional tool. Oh, that's so sweet, that's so handy. Get all these out of there. Get you out of there. Yeah. And get these little connector little pegs out. And we can begin the upgrade. We can rebuild him. We can make him stronger. Now, really, in this mode, only one piece is important, and that's this one right here. Now, this is actually really interesting. He took a bionicle piece, saw that it was actually roughly the same size he needed, and just went with it, made its own thing. It is translucent on the inside, painted on the outside, and all you do, I love this. I love this kit so much. It's got two little slots at the top that fit into these little grooves inside, the little orange bits, and a peg at the bottom that fits into the screw hole. So you just slide it right in place, give a little push, and it's as simple as that. That is amazing, and to me, it helps so much with the dino mode. Yes, most of you may not even notice. It's true. But to me, that helps a lot. Now, it is not 100% the same color as the plastic on Grimlock. It isn't, but it's not off by that much. It's just like a slight hue of difference. And it works, and you can even take his legs. There are little grooves along the inside where you can take his legs and fold them so they even fit in a little bit better to kind of make it a little more flush. And yeah, I really do like that. So there you go. That is worth it alone. Would I have paid $30 for that one little piece? I'm not going to answer that question. So all that's left to do now is really go to the rubber mode. But just to give you an idea real quick, so I don't have to show it off again, you can take these little pegs and they still, that still can store on Dynamite if you do want to. I didn't peg all the way because really there's absolutely no point to. The sword doesn't have a peg. So there's that. Let me get this guy transformed. And there we go. Now, one thing that I think is really kind of ingenious is that you don't even need to take out that little filler piece to put it in dino mode or in robot mode. You could leave it in if you want. You can take it out. The one drawback some of you might have is that Grimlock's head cannot fit inside his back anymore. I'm really okay with that. I'm okay with having just the dino head hanging out there. That doesn't bug me. I kind of like a little bit more, to be perfectly honest with you. I like having bits of dino just kind of hanging around. Now, you cannot replicate the whole lighting effect. Supposedly, you can. He did mention that the reason this is translucent with paint on it is so you can still have the light shining through. I have not been able to replicate that, so maybe I'm just doing it wrong. Supposedly, you can still do it. But, so yeah, you can just leave the head however you want. If you want to have it kind of tucked in more, give it more of an upwards backpack. You want to have it flat, it's definitely up to you. Another awesome thing with this set, just absolutely fun, is that you have his little weapons. Now, these aren't bad weapons. They really aren't. I like their design. I think they look okay. However, they are small for Grimlock. So, before we had this one, we now have this baby. Now, this thing, I have a feeling my lighting is not going to do it justice. This thing is absolutely beautiful in hand. It looks so well done. The kind of paint use on the actual handle, I guess the hilt, just looks so nice. You put them together, give an idea for how much the size is improved. This thing is nice. It has a really, really dull plastic. This thing is sharp. This thing is very, very sharp. So give that to Grimlock. And he's got himself a much bigger sword. A much, much bigger. And I like this. I like this so much. This looks so much better. It really does. The way the translucent plastic is, I can't show it off. In his video, you can see it a whole lot better. The way the light hits it, it has this really, really almost fiery kind of a glow to it. It's so well done. This is probably some of the best translucent plastic I've seen. It's so overwhelmingly nice. And one thing that I really do like is that I mentioned I think it's dumb to have weapons pegging onto the robot modes. I've never really cared for that kind of thing because for the most part, you just leave these ugly pegs on the weapons themselves. And that kind of compresses the look of the actual weapon. Now, if it's a peg that can fold away or it's actually functional to a blaster, that's perfectly fine. But for a sword, that just takes it away. I don't like that. So, no more pegs. I love it. I really do. It's the same influence of the original sword. He simply liked the way the sword looks, so he made it bigger. Kudos, I love it. Now you get to the shield, same thing as before. Shield looks nice, I do like it. However, the new one, leaps and bounds. This is a shield. This is a shield for Grimlock. This little thing, that'll protect his crotch. That's all that is. That is a proper shield. Again, same design as the original. He liked the design. He didn't feel it was worth changing. So exact same design, just bigger. And it also has that really nice translucent glow that one has. This thing has a really, really nice strong feel to it. And it actually feels a little bit stiffer than the actual original shield. So that's worth noting. But yeah, the plastic, the silvery just looks really, really nice. Kind of pops. And I love this. Now, the cool thing is, it comes with two ways to connect it. You have this one little peg. So you stick it in the back. And that allows you to peg it onto Grimlock's forearm like before. So you can have his little shield, which isn't so little anymore. Now, that's awesome. I do like that. Had to work it out of the shield there. It's a really nice, snug fit. But it also comes with this little L-shaped peg. You put that in there. I'm not sure if it matters really which way it goes in. I don't think it really does. It feels a little bit thicker. Gives it this little doohickey. So now Grimlock can actually hold his shield. And that's a thing that really wasn't needed, but I really do like it. It gives you a lot more options for posability. You can have Grimlock holding his shield in a lot more variety of ways. And it's a very, very minor change that really does bring a lot more oomph to this figure. I really do like that. That is awesome. That looks great. I think I actually kind of prefer it being held in his hand more than I did the whole forearm look. That pig's gonna try to roll away on me. Now, last but certainly not least, it comes with a new head. Now, I've sat and looked at these heads back and forth for a very long time, and I cannot decide which one I like more. For this head, he wanted to have kind of a G1 look, so he went with a replica of the Masterpiece head, scaled for this figure. And, you know, I like it, I do. There is no light piping if you are at all curious. You use the exact same screws from this guy, and to give an idea of how these things look, kind of take this, all you do... Have your precision screwdriver handy. I'm not going to show the whole thing on camera because really there's no point. But loosen these up and then pull the head off the ball joint. There's our beheaded Grimlock. Now to show you how these heads look together, there's the original one. There is the new one. Now, I like both their styles, but I can't tell if there's one that I like more than the other. I really can't. I'm going back and forth which one I actually want to use on the figure. I can't decide. I can't. But all you do, just loosen up these little screws, plop them out. These things are so handy. I've never used these these before. I've always just used a Phillips screwdriver, and it winds up stripping the screws out. This, no problem. Use the exact same screws. Now, he gave a really, really nice tip in his video that came in handy so much. If you want to have a really, really nice, proper, tight fit on this to where the seams actually fit together perfectly, it advises you to take the screws, put them in this part before assembly, and just tighten them in pretty much as far as you can go, just to thread these little holes. And that will allow you to screw the head on a whole lot better. It does. It works wonders. I kind of tried it beforehand and to see how it looked without doing that whole process. And it definitely was not a tight fit. The head was a little loose. Uh-oh. And after threading them through the plastic before assembling it properly, it worked wonders. It was amazing how much better it fit. I like to kind of get it started on here, and then when that's done, or at least somewhat started, you guys just pop it onto the ball joints and then finish the job. But you get an idea how it looks with the body. There's that. So let me go ahead and get this all tightened up. And ta-da! All done. All tightened up. Really nice, secure fit. It rotates. It's a very, very nice tight fit. The seams are tight together. Everything just looks great. It's one of those things where while I had no real desire to have an alternate head for Grimlock, these little arm bits pop off a lot. I do like this new one. So which one I'll wind up using, I'll probably just flip a coin and see, because I like them both. But yeah, that gives you an idea how it looks in the figure. Transforms still perfectly. You do have kind of, I think, angle the head up a little bit more to have enough clearance for the head to go around it, but it works easy peasy. You can still move the head a little bit in dino mode. So yeah, I like this set a whole lot. If you do have Grimlock, yes, the price tag being $30 is a bit of a, that kind of stinks, because it essentially is more expensive than the toy you're buying it for. But this improves the guy so much. I think it is essential. I'm going to say it. If you have this guy, this is an essential upgrade kit for him. It adds so much to the figure, the weapon, the shield. The alternate head is a nice alternative if you don't want to have the Fall of Cybertron type head. If you want to have something kind of more G1. If you're a G1er, you want to have a G1 head. There you go. And of course, having this added fillet for his back is really nice. Oh, speaking of that, with this piece in play, you don't have the same issue of his arms folding in on themselves. So if you're trying to pose his arm, I mentioned before how they kind of slide back into his body. Not anymore. It's got blockage now. It's actually got to hold it in place. So again, to show you how that fits in, it just comes right out. Line up these two little slots, these two little kind of a groove tab areas. Put that in place, peg it into his butt, and you're good to go. I love this set. Z, you did an excellent job. For your first set, this has wooed me. This has wooed me so much, and I look forward to what comes out in the future from you and Zenith Forge. This is an amazing set, and it made this figure so much more worth it. So there you go, guys. I have gushed way more than I planned to, but I really do love this set, and I would say pick it up. I got mine at Big Bad Toy Store. I'll have a link in the description if you want to get it there. As always, thanks for watching my silly little videos. I hope you have a great day, and I will see you around. Take care.